All right, so I'm going to show you a couple different ways to set up leg traps. We're going to start off with a dirt hole set. I'm going to use this bush here. I got a nice game trail running right through here, so I know there's coyotes and bobcats and foxes and whatever coming through here all the time. So I'm going to use this as a backdrop, and we'll get this one started. All right. Okay, so the main reason that we use a dirt hole set is to replicate a squirrel hole or a rabbit hole, and you know, that gets the coyote's attention. They see that hole, and they'll put a little piece of fur at the entrance of the hole, and you know, they'll come creeping up to it to investigate. Okay, so to start out here, we're gonna go ahead and open up our trap. Oh, by the way, so I made this piece of wood here, just a piece of plywood with a hole cut out in the middle, and it just lets all the, you know, the chain and everything sit, so that when you put the trap down, you got a nice solid surface to work with and everything's flat and level. Otherwise, if you're in dirt and it's soft and the trap is digging in while you're trying to do this whole process, you know, it just makes it more difficult. So, and now we have the trap set, we can actually use it to give us roughly an idea of how big of a hole we need to make. So I decided I'm gonna put it right about there. And so now I can kind of scratch out a little perimeter, give myself an idea of how big I need to cut out a hole. Set the trap off to the side, and we're just going to lightly scrape away about 2 inches or so, 2 or 3 inches. You know, the idea is that you want the trap to be resting on fairly solid ground, and then have it, you know, when you fill it in with your dirt on top, you have it nice and flush to the ground, so it doesn't look like a depression. Now we're just gonna set up our trap, kind of see what it looks like, and to me that looks pretty good. You know, it's a slightly, just a little bit below the surface, which is perfect. Okay, so before we get any further, I'm gonna go ahead and set our stakes. Now I got these little guys, it's just basically, looks like two washers kind of together. You can see they're at kind of an angle here. And what that allows you to do is cross stake it. So you take two stakes, I think these are like 15 inches. It's just a piece of rebar with a washer welded on the end. So you're just gonna hammer those in. You can see it's going in at an angle. And now this one here is gonna come in at the opposite angle and cross that one. You can use single stakes, but I find that, you know, if an animal, a big animal, you know, whatever it is, or just a really strong or really feisty animal, can pull a single stake out pretty easily. And that double cross thing, that's really tough to pull out. I mean, you gotta work really hard to get that out of there. So now what I want to do is I got some sifted dirt here, and I'm just gonna put a light layer. Oh yeah, normally I'd be wearing gloves, but since I'm only doing this for demonstration, I'm not really worried about leaving my scent behind. Okay, so I'm putting this soft dirt down, that way when I bed the trap, it can kind of settle in there, you know, and be kind of sturdy. The idea is that you want that thing to be really solid. Okay, so that's pretty good right there. So now I got my pan cover. So put that there, and what that does is just basically protects a lot of dirt from getting underneath the pan, because what you don't want to have happen is have a rock or a bunch of mud, you know, if the trap gets rained on, all that dirt will just kind of settle down in there and get underneath the pan, and you can step on it all day long and it's not going to go off. So that protects that prevents that. So now I'm going to go ahead and go around the edges. What I usually like to do is have at least a 5-gallon bucket of pre-sifted dirt, dried and ready to go, so that I don't have to mess around looking for any when I get out here. Now you're just going to go along, and this is important. You really want to get that dirt pushed down and compacted around the edges, because you don't want any movement. You know, for example, let's say the coyote comes over here and he steps on the edge right here and it moves, he's going to back off.
So you don't want that to happen. You know, you want them to step right on that pan.
That's pretty good. As you can see, I'm pushing on that trap and it's pretty solid in there. So now, just take, this is actually really good soil right here. I'm just gonna. Normally I would use my sifted dirt, but I just ran out. This will work fine. One thing about the trap bed itself, you don't wanna make this trap bed too big because then you're changing the consistency of the ground. You know, and as that animal is walking up, it's gonna be sensing that. So you don't want them to walk up, you know, and start feeling soft dirt way back here and then decide not to go any farther. So that's why I use the trap to measure out a nice tight trap bed. Now here's the delicate part. I know my pan is right there. But you know, you want to get this stuff pretty well compacted as best you can. Sometimes what you'll do is, before you put that dirt on top like I just did, maybe put a rock there just so you know where it is, because you want to keep track of where that pan is located. So now also what I'm doing, this little mound that's kind of being created, this wet dirt is going to kind of replicate, you know, when a squirrel digs a hole, let's say the hole's here, you know, they're pushing all that dirt out, so this looks very much like a squirrel hole. So, you know, a coyote is not going to be suspicious about that at all. That's something they see every day. And in fact, freshly dug up dirt is actually something that attracts them, because that usually means there's fresh animal activity going on in that area. So, you know, coyote's going to be walking by this trail. Whether I have bait here or not, he's going to smell that dirt, and he's going to come over here and just at least take a peek. And as you'll see what I'm about to do in a minute here, which I really should have done beforehand, but I haven't done this in a while. You go ahead and you dig out your hole. That's why I got this really thin blade here. So go ahead and dig that out. And this dirt is really wet, so it's kind of hard. It's not cooperating the best I'd like. You don't want to kind of go in and at an angle. You know, again, you're just trying to make it look like something lives here. There might be something to eat for a coyote. And that's really it. All you need to do is just, I don't know, 6 to 8 inches. I mean, you can go deeper if you want, but you don't need much. You know, a coyote's gonna see that just fine. I kind of lost track of my pan. There it is. Okay, so I know my pan is right there. Anywhere in this area right here, if a dog steps, we're in good shape. Get some of this grass and stuff out of here. Okay. So, now, the trap is set, everything's set. I'm gonna kinda go around here, compact that area. Like I said before, you want it to be compacted. You don't want the dog to step on soft dirt when he's not expecting it. You can kinda rough it up a little to make it look natural. But basically that's it right there. Okay, I got a rock on top of my thing, I don't want that. You want the top of the pan to be as clean as possible, and I'll show you why in just a minute. That's why that good sifted dirt is really important, because you put that on top of the pan kind of as a finishing touch. Okay, so there's that. Rough it up, try to make it look as natural as possible. Okay, now we gotta dress up the trap to make it look like something they want to come after. To do that, I got my bait. Got my trapping bag here. I got all kinds of little assortments of bait. I got some kind of lure, the tag wore off. I don't know what that is anymore. Canine Supreme. I don't know if you can see that. Canine Supreme. Adirondack lures. I have no idea what's in this stuff, but it's really nasty. So, I mean, it smells awful. Actually, not too bad for me. I get used to that stuff. But so now I got a bunch of little pieces of rabbit fur. I just took a cottontail rabbit,
killed it, skinned it, stretched the skin out, let it dry, and had the rabbit for lunch. Now this stuff's good, serves a couple of different purposes. I'm gonna take a couple pieces out of here. One, it's used as just something to hold the bait. So I'm gonna take a stick, any old stick that you find on the ground. I'm gonna take a nice size glob. As you can see, it's about the size of a lima bean or something. And I'm just gonna get it on that rabbit fur and just get it down in that hole. That's just gonna smell, that's gonna make the trap smell real good. Okay, that's your bait right there, that's your lure. Now, I like to take just a piece of this fur, or you can use a brightly colored feather. You know, the brighter the better. And you're gonna wanna just kinda set it up. Like somewhere they're gonna see it. So they walk up and they see, oh, what's that little piece of fur there? You know, maybe there's a dead rabbit in that hole sticking out. Okay. Kinda get it to hold in there best you can. Somehow. Whatever, it'll probably fall, but you know, it'll be there. Okay, next. Now you can't see it in this view, obviously I've got it closed in on the trap, but there's a big bush here behind the trap, so I know, and there's a trail behind me, so I know that no animal is going to come from this direction. They're going to be coming specifically from this direction, and I got a little branch sticking out here, and I got a branch about, I don't know, a foot away from where my hand is right here. So I know this is my path. So what I want to do is further condense that path to make it so this is the only path they can take up to that hole. So now I'm just going to take things like rocks. I'm going to put a rock here just for fun. You can take some broken sticks. Let's take a branch, place it here, because you know a dog is not going to want to step on a branch. You know, if he's walking up to this, he's going to step here or here. He's not going to step on the branch. There's just no way. So I'm taking these branches, just random little pieces, and I'm just going to kind of do this. Just kind of, I'm going to create a little runway. You know, he's going to see that and he's going to go, well, I don't want to step here. I want to go right here. So, you know, you just do that. You just kind of make sure that that is the only way any coyote is going to want to come into this trap. Like that. Okay, so now I got about a 12 inch wide path, which is decent. That's the size of any kind of game trail you're gonna find. So now I gotta make it so he does, you know, he has to step exactly there. So how do I do that? Well, now I take smaller things like little twigs, little things like that, and like that, and like that, you know, and little rocks or whatever you can find. You know, maybe put one right there, and even right there. So now for sure he's gonna step there, right? Because he's not gonna step there, we know that. You know, and just kinda do that. Just kinda dress it up a little bit. You know, make it look like, okay, you're giving him choices. He's gonna step here, and then he's gonna step there. That's pretty obvious. You know, I'll put a little bit of rocks here. Maybe that'll deter him from stepping on top of that first. So now for sure, he's gonna step here, here, and here. And as soon as he steps there, he's done. So I will demonstrate that right now because I'm not going to leave this trap out. Let's say I'm a coyote walking up. I'm gonna step here, step here, step there, done. Coyote is toast, as you can see. And he can pull all day long and that thing's not coming out of the ground. No coyote's gonna be strong enough to pull that out of there. And that's it. That's a dirt hole set right there for you. Okay, so now we got a trail here. There's a trail about 12 inches wide. I got a bush here and a bush here. So there's absolutely no way that a dog is gonna go anywhere but right here. So we will take advantage of that. Now we're gonna do exactly the same thing we did over there, except we're not going to use a dirt hole because we're not trying to attract them to this spot. We already know they're going to come through here. So all we got to do is just make it so when they step on that pan, the trap goes off.
just really important to get the dirt compacted underneath the trap so that the trap doesn't move. See how that moves? Not good. So you just want to keep pushing it in around the edges until you get it to where it's holding that trap in real still. Like I said before, if the coyote steps on that edge and it moves, he's gonna spook. You know, it's gonna get his attention real quick. You know, or bobcat or whatever, they're very sensitive to what they're stepping on. You know, they don't like to step on debris, they like to step on nice clean areas. Especially cats. Mountain lions, bobcats, they're really particular about where they step. They're very light-footed. I know I want it right in that middle there. I mentioned before about marking that spot, you know, you can just take a stick or something. So, now we do the same thing we did over there, you know, just take some sticks, just reach around, you know, on a bush and just kind of set them up, kind of randomly. I remember focusing on this spot right here. In fact, there I can see my pan is right exactly there. So I know that is the target area right there. So we're gonna make sure when that animal comes through here, they have no choice other than to put their foot exactly right there. Now you can even narrow it right down to that spot. You don't wanna make it too tight because then he'll just skip right over the whole thing. So, you know, make it look like that's a place you wanna put your foot. You know, when he steps there, game over. Just like that. Now the only reason I don't like to use a trap in the middle of a trail is because you never know what you're gonna catch. You know, this happens to be a trail that I know that cattle use this trail, I know deer use this trail, I know pigs use this trail, mountain lions, bobcats, coyotes, any animal that lives on this ranch that comes in this area is gonna come down this trail. You could catch a skunk, a badger, a raccoon. You never know what you're gonna catch in a trap like this. The dirt hole set that we showed earlier, that's more specific. You know, you're really kind of targeting predators, animals that are seeking out rodents and things. So that's a much better trap if you're going specifically for coyotes or bobcats. And there you have it. That's it. I hope that hope you have a lot of luck out there on the trap line, and see you next time.